The wife of Bath begins her prologue by announcing that she has always followed the rules of experience rather than authority. And since she has had 5 husbands at the church door, she has had a great amount of experience. She sees nothing wrong with having had 5 husbands and cannot understand Jesus' rebuke to the woman at the well, who had also had 5 husbands. She prefers the biblical injunction to, quote, increase and multiply, unquote. She reminds the pilgrims of several biblical incidents. Solomon and his many wives, the command that a husband must leave his family and join with his wife, and St. Paul's warning that it is better to marry than to burn. Having shown herself to have a knowledge of the Bible, she asks where it is that virginity is commanded. It is, she admits, advised for those who want to live a perfect life. But she admits that she is not perfect. Moreover, she asks, what is the purpose of the sex organs? They were made for both functional purposes and for pleasure. And unlike many cold and bashful women, she was always willing to have sex whenever her husband wanted to. The partner interrupts and says that he was thinking of getting married, but having heard the wife of Bath, he is glad that he is single. She responds that she could tell more, and the partner encourages her to do so. The wife then relates stories concerning her 5 husbands. She recalled that 3 of them were very old and good and rich, and she will now reveal how she was able to control each one. Her techniques were very simple. She accused her husbands, the first 3 husbands, of being at fault. She scolded them when they accused her of being extravagant with clothes and jewelry when her only purpose was to please her husband. She railed at her husband when he refused to disclose the worth of his land and the value of his coffers. She derided the husband who considered her as property. She denounced men who refused her the liberty of visiting her friends. For women, like men, like freedom. She decried the husband who suspected her chastity was in danger every time she smiled at another gentleman to whom she wished only to be courteous. She denounced the husband who hired spies to determine if she was unfaithful, and indeed hired her own witnesses to testify to her faithfulness to her marriage bed. Each time she gained complete mastery over one of her husbands, he would then die. But her 4th husband was different. He kept a mistress, and this bothered her because she was in the prime of life and full of passion. Thus, while not being actually unfaithful to her 4th husband, she made him think so. Thus, quote, in his own grease I made him fry, unquote. But now he is dead, and when she was burying him, she could hardly keep her eyes off a young clerk named Jankin, whom she had already admired. Thus, at the month's end, she married for a 5th time, even though she was twice the clerk's age. And this time she married for love and not riches. But as soon as the honeymoon was over, she was disturbed to find that the clerk spent all of his time reading books, especially books which disparaged women. In fact, he collected all the books he could which told unfavorable stories about women, and he spent all his time reading from these collections. One night, he began to read aloud from his collection. He began with the story of Eve and read about all the unfaithful women, murderesses, prostitutes, etc., which he could find. The wife of Bath could not stand this anymore. So she grabbed the book and hit Jangin so hard that he fell over backwards into the fire. He jumped up and hit her with his fist. She fell to the floor and pretended to be dead. When he kneeled over her, she hit him once more and pretended to die. He was so upset that he promised her anything if she would live. And this is how she gained sovereignty over her fifth husband. And from that day on, she was a true and faithful wife for him.